Hey people, my name is Gerben and I'm surrounded right now by a lot of packages with all kinds of computers. I'm sometimes not even sure anymore about what's inside the box. But today we're going to unpack some more and finally, gradually, get away of these packages. I've been a seller and a collector of vintage computers for a very, very long time. And let's have a look what we've got. Next computer was not very expensive because it was for free. Yes, it was. And sometimes people offer old computers for free. And I ask them to send it to me, and I offer them a little bit extra for their troubles. And sometimes they say, well, it's too much trouble, it's too big, it's too heavy, it's too whatever. And they're talking maybe about a Commodore 64. I don't think it's very heavy, but okay. And anyway, and lots of times people say, oh, okay, I will do this, and I pay them a little bit extra, and there is a nice computer in the next box, and we'll have a look. Not too much bigger box, and it looks very good. And there is in here, of course, an MSX machine, because MSX is always one of my best sellers, so I'm always interested in MSX machines. And let's have a look. It's a nice old MSX machine, the Gold Star. It's a little bit yellowed and it needs some cleaning, but it looks good. And it was, well, basically for free, so I cannot complain. And here we have a little bit better look of the machine. It's the Gold Star. You see that it has a little dent in the plastic. This is too bad. Gold Star is originally from South Korea. I sold many of these back to South Korea, and it's always very funny to see some old computer going around the world and making somebody very happy. Typically there is a hole for the light pen, and I saw this keyboard and I was thinking, this key, what will it do? Let's test it and see what this key does. Okay, let's turn it on. That's good. Well, that's too bad. It does turn on, but the screen is only blank, so nothing else happens. I like to show you this. Made in Korea. Very, very special. Next item is another big box. I know I say this all the time, but it is a big box. And it's quite heavy, especially. It's an old computer, and I hope it's packed well, because I'm not really sure. Because the box is almost as big as the computer, so there's not enough room for packing. We'll have a look. Another big box, and quite heavy. It's really heavy. Sometimes I rattle the box to hear if there's something loose inside. I'm not sure about this one. We'll just have to look. This is more hopeful. A lot of bubble wrap. That's always good. Bubble wrap is one of the easiest way to protect stuff, I think. Not always the best way, but and it's not always very cheap, but anyway, I'm not sure if you can see what it is. Maybe you can see already, but of course I'm gonna show you. It's a vintage IBM 80 machine. It's one of the most heavy machines, like the 5160 and the 5150. The XT's machines are not as heavy as the 80 machines. They are really the big beasts. It looks pretty good, and come and have a look. Here we have the closer look of the machine. It looks pretty okay. But I'm not sure about these. They're not original, I think. I'm not really sure. Did it have turbo? I'm not sure. 1.2 megabyte drive, 360 kilobyte drive. There's something supposed to be a lid here, I think. And of course the big, very nice knob. That's always very cool. And in the back, some more questions. We need to bend this again. There's supposed to be IBM logo here, but that's not. So we have a look inside what we've got. And some cards. We'll open it up and see what we have inside. And now we have opened it up. It looks like everything is okay here. Some cards. So EGA, that is very nice because it's very uncommon to find your in and out card and some others. A big hard drive. That was a nice surprise with the original front. The floppy drives, and I think we'll have to test it and see what we've got. Okay, everything plugged in, and let's see what it's doing. My monitor is not picking up any signal, but maybe it's not capable of EGA. I flipped the switch in the back, I hope that helps. And still we don't have any screen output. On the back of the card there's some little dip switches, and we're going to try those. I found some info on the internet. Let's hope that we can get this thing working. And now there's something going on. We have a cursor. Okay, this is good news. Of course the hard drive could be failing, but at least we have a working computer, like it seems. Let's see if we can boot from floppy. Thank you. And it's doing a little bit more now. Look at this. Still saying it's a boot failure, but I think the DOS version may be too modern for this machine. Oh, and here we go. Something is happening and it is all good, it seems. This is very good. No. I think I'm happy. Yes, I am. The next computer may be not really, really vintage or retro, but I need it. I need it for my business. Besides selling old computers, I also make a lot of discs for the really old, mostly CPM machines. And maybe you've seen some of these computers already in my videos. You must have, because they are right over here and over here. Let's see what we got. The box is not really, really big, and I think it's packaged okay. Let's have a look what's inside this box. It says breakbaar, it means fragile. Maybe he was planning on sending it like this. I'm happy he put another box around it, and I don't hear any shaking or any rambling. That's always a good sign, huh? Let's see. Some papers and a disk drive. Look at this, another shuttle PC. It's got a blue front. It's very, very futuristic, and I think it's very nice. It looks good and it looks clean, and we'll have a closer look. Here we have a better look at the shuttle. It's another Shuttle X. I have a Shuttle X, and I'm hoping this machine does what it wants, what I want it to do, because I'm hoping I can fit a 360 kilobyte disk drive in here, the big 5.25 flip floated disk drives, and that it will work with it, and so I can make more disks. Don't park it on the disk. No. 3.5 inch floppy drive and a video card. It's all looks good, and we'll try it out. Okay, everything hooked up, and let's have a look. This sounds fine. Looks like there's no operating system on the hard drive, if there is any hard drive at all. And we'll have a look in the BIOS. And here we are. Let's see. And first we're gonna check this. And yes, oh, this is very nice. This is the one I want. This is the one I need, and it has a B too. Where should we put the B? Oh, we can. Oh, yeah, of course. I've got already one shuttle that has a 5.25 and a 3.5 inch disk drive. This is really cool. Yes, I'm really, really happy with this. And just for fun, we are going to put in
a disk and see if it boots from CD-ROM. And it does. So it seems. Well, it took some time, but now it booted into Ubuntu 30-bit version, of course, and it seems to work all fine. I'm really glad with this computer, I think. Next up is another very cool and nice vintage machine. It came from Belgium. This time I was able to buy something not from the Netherlands, but from Belgium. Doesn't matter. Postage is a little bit more, but it was still a very good deal. It's one of the, well, it's maybe the best, one of the best MSX machines. It's the top of the Philips line. And if I'm telling you that, then you already know what I'm talking about if you're into MSX. And now let's have a look what we've got. Oh, and I have to say that there is a little bit of damage. I know it was already sold to me like that, and just let us hope that it's not more, there's more damage, because that would be very unfortunate. But let's have a look. A very big box, and it's always good news because they took enough space and filling, I hope, to protect this computer very well. If the box is very small and your computer is very big, then you're, well, maybe you're in trouble. But it's this time I think we're very lucky. Let's open this this baby. This is the keyboard for the machine. It looks very nice. It's got all the same color. Typically, this row of keys is a different color, because I'm not sure. Maybe it's at something in the factory. Maybe it came from another factory. A lot of these keyboards, they have a color difference in the keys. This one does not have this, and it is all nice and gray. I think this is a very good keyboard, and this seems very promising for the rest of the machine. Not unpacked already, but I told the seller, sometimes I'm a bit cheeky maybe, but I'm telling people how to pack this, and I especially told him to pack this like I do. I wrap it around in plastic first, bubble plastic on the front, cardboard on the front, and then all protected in the box, and that is the best way to ship these. And no, I'm very happy he listened to me, and we'll see what if everything has survived. And here we go, a very nice Philips NMS8280. It's the video computer. Its front is already broken and fixed again. I think it looks very good. Of course, the price was not as big as high, I have to say. If the front was all nice, and it would be all nice. So it was a good opportunity, and let's test this baby out. And here we have it, the MSX beast of a machine. You can see there has been some repairs
on the front, and I think maybe it took a drop somewhere, and I think more likely it's been shipped to somebody and not in the right way, and it was damaged, and they repaired it very nice because they all have all the plastics they are. So it's okay. I think maybe here we have, what shall we have here? A phone for your headphones, or I'll have a closer look. Here you have the little sliders, two disk drives, and I hope these disk drives work because stuff is getting old. And here we have the very nice keyboard. As I said, there's a little bit, well, if you're looking very good, you can see there's a little bit of discoloring here. It's not very serious, and it looks very nice. Two cartridge ports on the side, and in the back we can see as well that it's 8280, because we have a lot of connectors, all video, audio, everything. And we can see there's something not original. And can you see what it is? Please leave a comment if you can see what is not original about the backside of this fine machine. And let's have a look. It's the type number is 00. Some collectors think this is very important because there were the 00s, the 20s, the 30s and the 40s, I think. I'm not really sure about that. And let's hook this baby up and see what it does, shall we? Let's see. And here we can see which drive is A. Sometimes they are switched. This time it's the left one. And let's see how it does on the screen. Well, this looks very good. And let's try out some games and some disk drives if they work. And this and is here we have the last DOS thing I do. It is a home mode. It's a double disk sided computer. This is a lot of fun. Can I go up? Hello. I want to go up. Oh. Oh. Oh, that's no good. Well, this works fine. Thank you.
Okay. Something from 92. That's after my MSX years, I think. There's some very curious what this is going to be. A guest from Holland. Okay. Don't talk to him. This looks very colorful. Oh. I don't think I have to. For me. Hey. Yep. Yes. Oh. Oh. That's okay. I don't yeah. Oh. Yes, it's okay. Too bad.
Right, we came to the end of the video. I hope you liked it. I like making these videos a lot because it's always fun unpacking and showing other people what came in the mail. And video editing is also a lot of work. So if you enjoyed it, please subscribe because that really helps. And I hope to see all of you next time. Bye bye.